Ivan Pinto, what's the latest?
Not too bad, so quite normal. So his muscle gets a little bit tired after 60 minutes, and I think after 68, 69 minutes he had a cramp, and so because he was tired, so we had to substitute him. I don't go too deep with it, so I think it's quite normal. Like I said, so he missed all the preseason. Right now it was his second appearance. Had one appearance in the cup over 70 minutes. Right now over 70 minutes, so it's quite normal that he can't be there with 100%. I said so. I think after the national break he will be there with 100%. If it would be so easy to reach 100% without doing a preseason, we all would do without the preseason, because it's quite a hard time. It means hard working. So if it would be possible, so we will meet 1 week before the season starts and come all together and play the season. So it's quite normal. So I think it is important for him to get many minutes. It was important to have him on the pitch, but we have to be careful with him because he's not there with 100%. We have to wait a little bit. So yesterday he just recreates. We have to wait how the training in the afternoon will develop. But I think he can travel with us. Perhaps there is a setback, but I think he can travel with us. Yeah, good guy. Still a young guy, but when you recognized him in the last year, so he improved from year to year. He's very good with a head, so strong mentality, very good character. So I spoke to him last time yesterday, and really, really good guy. Pretty motivated. Perhaps a little bit too soon to bring him right now in the championship. So we think it's good for him to play many games and have many minutes to improve. And I think a good signing right now, but we will give him some time to improve and to have some minutes right now, and have the option in the winter to decide if he's already strong enough for the championship or whatever we'll do in January. But it's still a good option for us, and I think a good signing. Quite similar type, so I think it's important for our game. So when you analyze the last season, we concede a lot of goals because of headers. So we said, okay, we have to be better in this area, especially in set pieces. And so when our philosophy is to press the opponent high, they often use the long balls, and then it's always good to have a good guy who's good in head with a head. And I think it makes sense, such a signing. No, we're still awake, so we're still awake because it's a signing for the future, not for this window. So like I said before, I'm really content with the squad right now. So there is no pressure, and there's no greater plan, or we're not forced to search for a special position or whatever. But when there is perhaps a good option, we will be awake, but we don't have to. Yes, for sure. Aston Villa is a massive club, and also always a great challenge to be there. And with a great history, we know it will be really hard game for us, especially because like I said, the third game in 6 days, they were able to recreate 1 day more. And to be honest, I would prefer that they had a little bit better start, so they're not under this pressure. So I expect them pretty motivated and really aggressive, and for sure they will be there with a big will to get their first win, especially in the home game. And so it will be quite hard, and I think a game with lots of intensity, and we have to prepare for it, and hopefully we will be there. So it will be hard, but that's what you're searching for when you're a footballer. So you're always searching for hard competition and big challenges, and we're looking forward to. We know it will be a big challenge, but we're looking forward to. Yes, there was a small operation. Was just a small thing, but sadly we have to confirm that we will have to do without him the next 4 months. So it means a break of I think 13 weeks or something like that, the first diagnosis. So really really sad for the guy, really sad for us, because he was really brilliant in preseason and improved from day to day. But it is like it is. We have to handle it, and we're looking forward to see him, have him back in the squad, perhaps the beginning of 2018. Yes, for sure, because in the beginning it was not clear. So what are the problems and how long have we and why are the problems there? So it develops from one day overnight to another day. So yeah, really sad for him because he worked a lot and was close to the starting 11 and to be honest, he was a really good option as on the left fullback position. Yeah, it's really hard and sad for him, and yeah, to be honest, hard and sad for us too. But it's like it is, and yeah, we have to handle it. Very close, because he's physically in a very good condition. So he had the whole preseason at German second Bundesliga's VfL Bochum. He was there I think they had 34 games in the last season. He was there in the starting lineup, 32 games, so very good condition. I was very content with his first 9 minutes on Wednesday evening. So when I just watched his running distance in 9 minutes, he covered, I think, 1.4 kilometers. So when he did this over 90 minutes, so it's a new record for the whole championship, I think. So it means, so it's really, really an unbelievable good physical condition, and this good guy. And for sure, he needs a little bit to get used to everything, but the first days he was a little bit nervous, but right now he's close to the team and he's possible to be in the starting 11 for sure.